Exclusive new details now on the search for a missing Kansas City baby girl. It's been 3 weeks since now 11-month-old Lisa Irwin disappeared, triggering a desperate search. Tonight, Lisa's family held a candlelight vigil for her return as ABC News gets inside access to a potentially crucial location in the case. This is the first look inside the master bedroom in baby Lisa's home, where cadaver dogs detected the scent of a human corpse. Cindy Short, the family attorney, gave ABC News an exclusive tour after an exhaustive police search this weekend.
Is that if you had the dog in here and it allegedly alerted, you might notice as you walk around that there's no carpet taken from this room.
Short noted that from the little evidence taken, it wasn't clear why investigators spent 17 hours here.
And it almost seems as if that was more for the public's benefit than for the benefit of doing a thorough search in this house.
Deborah Bradley admitted she was drinking from this wine box the night her daughter disappeared. Her shifting timeline and comments have aroused police suspicion, among the most concerning that she was afraid to look outside because of what she might find. But her family insists 11-month-old Lisa was abducted. They point to two separate witnesses who both saw a suspicious man carrying a naked baby in the middle of the night. At 2:30 a.m., right between those two eyewitness sightings, new exclusive surveillance video of this dumpster shows a man at the top left of your screen who seems to just come out of the forest. But so far, police haven't been able to connect all those dots.
The police obviously, at least at some point, believed that perhaps Mrs. Bradley had something to do with baby Lisa's disappearance. I think that's still out there.
An anonymous donor is now offering a $100,000 reward for baby Lisa's safe return. And meanwhile, billboards are now up in Kansas City asking anyone if they recognize baby Lisa. The signs flash information about the missing 11-month-old for drivers to be able to see.